Hey guys, Andrea here. I'm with Phil Spencer, the head of all of things Xbox. Well, Microsoft Game Studios to be exact. How's it going? We're here at Xbox One Preview. You guys are less than a month away from launch.
It's incredibly exciting. Nervous. No, no. The nice thing is now, most of the games here are actually in certification. So we're now just trying to build boxes and get the games done. It's been kind of an incredible run to launch. Great to see all the games here.
So you guys have a pretty impressive lineup of games that are coming out.
Thank you.
For launch day for your internal studio. How much preparation does it take to launch all of these games simultaneously?
Yeah, it starts 3 years ago. 3 years ago when you're starting to think about what Durango will be, the code name for Xbox One, when it's going to launch, looking at the different games and where they are in development. Some of them early, just kind of sparkles in someone's eye. Some of them further along. And then trying to make sure you have a great lineup. We've got over 20 titles at launch. Because somebody's investing a lot of money in a new game console, and they want to know that I'm going to have the best games possible there at launch. But also already planning for next holiday and the holiday beyond, because it's a long-term investment for people in a studios. You got to pre-plan. It's just part of the job.
Are you guys happy with what you ended up with your launch lineup? Are there things that you wish you would have been able to get into there, or things that maybe you are nervous about?
Kind of knock on wood, it really fell into place really well for us. You want to have a racing game at launch. We've had Project Gotham Racing on the last two Xboxes at launch, and the Turn 10 team signed up with Forza 5 to have Forza Motorsport 5 at launch. I think it looks incredible, 1080p, 60 frames a second. You know, Rise was the game that I really wanted to have at launch. Crytek had never done a launch game. They'd never been first party before. They have such a just amazing capability of art and technology to put something great on screen. So talking with Shavat about turning Rise into a launch game for Xbox One, and now I'm playing it every night, and it's the best looking thing I've ever seen on console. So it's been incredible. And then, you know, looking forward a little bit, having Titanfall coming in March, I think you're going to get, we'll have a ton of volume, a ton of people coming in the holiday, and what a great next step for people early in the next year to have such a huge console exclusive like Titanfall coming to the platform. It's great.
I call Titanfall a system seller for Xbox One. Would you agree with that statement?
Seems like it, right? You go to the shows and the lines are incredible. I'm sure you've seen it, right?
Oh,
everybody
yeah.
comes
Even
out.
Even press
and
is waiting in line
I know,
to play that game.
And tweeting expletives and like people just love Titanfall. But it's a studio with such a great track record. So I think it's easy to look at Respawn. For us, working with Electronic Arts and Respawn on the game, having it coming to Xbox is exclusively, absolutely a system seller, a great time for us coming in March after launch lineup, and I think it's just gonna own spring. I think it'll just create this crater about the size of a Titan, and everybody will be playing online, which will be fantastic.
I absolutely agree with you 100%. So when Microsoft launched Xbox 360, you guys did a lot of stuff to really engage the community and really kind of push that console within the community. Are we going to see specific events that you guys are going to hold to try to get the fans of Xbox really excited about the launch of One?
Yeah. You know, I remember Area 1 that we did on 360 launch, which was really cool, kind of out in the desert. And we have similar programs in place that you'll start to hear more about with Xbox One. There's also going to be a real digital push, because one thing that we've grown through the 360 generation are millions and millions of people on live and some very dedicated customers. And there's actually ways for us to reach out to our most dedicated customers on live and thank them. And again, you'll hear more about that coming, but definitely rewarding our best fans and welcoming everybody into the Xbox One kind of family, whether they've been along from the original Xbox or they're new. We want to make sure our arms are wide open, they can come and play the games, they can feel what it means to be an Xbox supporter. We'll have a lot of things between now and launch and beyond, right? It's just going to continue to grow.
Are we going to see any special things on Xbox Live, like during the launch window, like on launch day or, you know, in the weeks after that gamers can, you know, kind of mark their calendars for?
Yeah, you've actually started to see some of that already. I know there was a redesign on Xbox.com to start get ready for the launch of Xbox One, and you'll start to see more functionality coming on Xbox Live on 360 as well as when you get your new console on Xbox One. try to welcome people in. We've also got content that will be there available. So we've got Killer Instinct that anybody can go download and play. You're gonna have Xbox Fitness that's available for free to everybody who's an Xbox Live Gold subscriber. We've got Xbox Kinect Sports Rivals preseason that'll be there, so people have things that they can play day one to both kind of reward and welcome people in. But the Live is a huge asset for us. It's a huge community of over 40 million people on Xbox Live now. We want to continue to grow that and make it more important even than on Xbox One than it has been on 360, continue to push it.
When Xbox 360 launched, social media was not really a factor in pushing the launch of that console because that was pre-Twitter, pre the YouTube integration
that
we're seeing now.
Can't remember that far back.
I know, right? It was forever ago. I mean, that we were talking last night about how it makes the challenges of marketing so much more unique now in this era than it was then. Are there certain things that you guys are doing to really integrate social media, or does social media present any challenges to your team?
Well, I think you do definitely have to manage it and listen. We've had feedback over the summer, I think everybody knows that, and having those channels of feedback come in frequently with a lot of volume definitely impacts what you're doing as you're building your product. I think that's a good thing, right? As I look forward and I say, we're gonna build this service, in some ways the 22nd is the beginning of the journey, not the end. And that feedback loop with gamers is really gonna be fundamental to how we build the service pushing out. There are actually things that you'll see in Xbox One that react to what people see. A couple things, game DVR, so actually allowing me to capture my gameplay, add my own voiceover or picture in a picture, and then share it out so that I can actually become a broadcaster, so to speak, of my own gameplay experiences. Now in Xbox Live, we have this notion of friends and followers. So I can follow somebody famous like you, and I can just see what you play.
I'm not famous, come on now.
But the that we've looked at other systems like Twitter, and we've said, how can we build out Xbox Live to actually show with that kind of viral dynamic that you see with Twitter and other systems, and how can that work inside of Xbox? I think it's going to be a really incredible launch pad for a lot of people on Xbox One when it comes out, of them building their own identity online through Xbox. It'll be fun to watch.
I'm certainly looking forward to putting out lots of gameplay videos. No one's going to watch them. I'm not that good. So for 360, I think it could be argued that Bungie was a developer that was really iconic with the whole generation of the 360.
Yeah.
Are there any developers that you think will define the generation of Xbox One?
It's a great question. It's funny, if you look over the last year or so, you might say Mojang has been had incredible impact on Xbox 360. I know you're asking about Xbox One, but it's just interesting to see the impact not only different developers can have, but different styles and kind of creatives in games and the impact they have on our ecosystem. I won't run away from Bungie. I think Bungie is going to have a huge impact on Xbox One. And Destiny coming to Xbox One is going to be a great game. They're friends of mine. They're just down the street from where I live. And I think they're going to do an incredible job with Destiny. But this generation, I don't know if this is much about the studio, but a game I'm really excited about is something we're building called Project Spark, mm-hmm. which really puts in the hands of millions of creators the tools to go create their own games. Now, they're not going to build Rise using Project Spark, but when you unleash the capability of anybody to tell their own stories, to build their own characters, to kind of program in a lightweight way their own scenes and share those with people, whether on Windows or they're on Xbox, I think you're going to see just a lot of creativity that comes out of that. I remember the first time I saw Red versus Blue with Halo. You remember that?
And yeah, absolutely. Like,
I think you're going to see those same kind of things with Project Spark. And I think something like that could have a huge impact this next generation.
Now, listen, I could keep talking to you forever because there's so many questions I have. So many. But I wanted to end with, this is the question I want to end with. Xbox One has had a very interesting ramp up towards launch, for lack of a better way to say that. Is there anything that you wish you guys would have done differently, or is there anything that you're particularly proud of?
Yeah, I mean, this will sound kind of silly. I wish it would have been much easier for us if the games at E3 were in the state they were now, because I think in the end people play the games, and I think the questions that people had around what this gaming ecosystem is going to be like, they couldn't reflect our announcements against a great lineup of games that they could put their hands on and play. So what I'm really excited about is how that plan has really come to bear through summer, now into the fall, as I see the games land. But I think it's a little bit like some of the resolution discussions or some of the DRM policy discussions. If you don't have the content, if you don't have the experience, then it's easy to get fixated on just parts of the system and not think about it completely. And that's just a challenge whenever you're announcing a product and talking about it. What I'm most proud of is really how the studios have come together to create, I think, a really compelling, the best launch lineup we've ever had. People are working incredibly hard. I can see a little bit of relief now in the system as the games are getting done. But the teams have all just kind of buckled together, learned from each other. I think it's going to be a really fun launch, not just to somebody in the Xbox group, but for gamers as well. And I'm really proud of what the teams have done.
Well, Phil, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with me today. I know that I'm personally really excited for Xbox One, and I hope all of our fans out there are as well. We, of course, will bring you guys lots of coverage of Xbox One right here on The Escapist, and thank you so much again.
Thanks.